हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। सो टुडे वी विल टेक वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिएक्शन, दैट इज़ द यूज़ ऑफ द रिएक्शंस ऑफ 1,3-dithiene, राइट? दिस इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक एंड आई हैव सीन नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन इट। सो फर्स्ट वी विल ट्राई टू बिल्ड अप द कंसेप्ट ऑन ऑफ इट एंड देन वी विल सॉल्व क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम CSIR नेट एंड गेट। सो फर्स्ट थिंग इज dithienes, these 1,3-dithienes कैन बी प्रिपेयर्ड बाई द मेथड सिमिलर टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एसिटाल। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, सपोज आई हैव एल्डिहाइड एंड आई एम यूजिंग 1,3-dithiol इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ एसिडिक कंडीशन, इट विल फॉर्म दिस 1,3-dithiene। सो द रिएक्शन मैकेनिज्म इज ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एसिटाल। देन वी कैन यूज अ बेस, जनरली ब्यूटाइल लिथियम इज यूज और एल डी ए कैन बी यूज एंड दिस बेस विल रिमूव अ एसिडिक प्रोटोन एंड वी नो दैट दिस कार्बन कैरिंग प्रोटोन इज हाईली एसिडिक बिकॉज इट इज क्लोज टू टू सल्फर्स। सो इट विल रिमूव दिस प्रोटोन एंड वी विल हैव अ नेगेटिव चार्ज ऑन दिस कार्बन, मीन्स वी हैव कार्बेनायन हेयर। देन वी कैन यूज दिस कार्बेनायन इन फर्दर रिएक्शन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आई एम रिएक्टिंग इट विद द हेलाइड, सो दिस नेगेटिव चार्ज विल अटैक हेयर एंड आर विल बी रिमूव्ड। वी कैन यूज सपोज HgCl2 एंड वी विल डू इट्स हाइड्रोलिसिस, सो दिस पोर्शन दिस 1,3-dithiol विल बी रिमूव्ड एंड वी हैव कीटोनिक ग्रुप अटैच्ड हेयर इफ यू आर यूजिंग दिस Hg+2 एंड यू डूइंग इस acidic hydrolysis. If I am using raninical here, then it will do simple its reduction to CH2 group, right? We will see one question based on it also. So it will give me ketonic group here. So what is the important part of this reaction? That this carbon, which is going to be electrophilic in ketone, is now acting as a nucleophile. Right, this process is called as amp along and I have already created a video on it. So if you want to understand that part, you can go there, right? You can watch my video on amp along, but here we will concentrate other reactions of this 1,3-dithiene. The basic mechanism is same, that there is a change in the electrophilicity of this carbon. It is nucleophile, now it will become electrophilic in nature. So the basic concept is similar to that, but we will mainly focus on the questions from CSIR NET and GATE. So in this way we will have ketone here. Next important point is these dithienes are more stable than acetal, right? Then they can ask you one more important thing, that this sulfur in 1,3-dithiene is basic, that is more basic or less basic than oxygen. If I am using a acetal here, then they can ask us that this sulfur will be more basic or oxygen will be more basic. So the answer is this sulfur will be less basic. How you will define it? Suppose I am using a acid here. So this sulfur will give its lone pair of electron to this acid, right? Then to stabilize this sulfur, suppose this sulfur will give its lone pair of electron and this bond will break. So what you are forming here, you are forming a sulfur carbon double bond, right? We can form carbon carbon double bond, carbon oxygen double bond, but this sulfur carbon double bond will be very weak in nature, because this bond is formed by the overlapping of 2p orbital of carbon and 3p orbital of sulfur. So there is poor overlap between them, that is why this bond is weak in nature, right? And the sulfur is less basic than oxygen. So these two points are also very important and they can ask question related to. Then we will take some questions and try to build up our concept of this reaction. So first thing is we are using a base here, so this proton will be removed, so we have a carbanion here. Then the most important point is this carbanion will attack on this carbon or it will attack on this one. So only remember a simple concept, because this is a bulkier group, so it will attack on less hindered carbon, right? We have studied in a Claydon book summary that for allylic halides, the substitution reaction can be SN substitution nucleophilic reaction or SN prime type reaction, right? And the reaction mechanism depends upon the type of your carbon ion and the group attached to the allyl halide. So because this carbon is also hindered in nature, that is why it will not attack on it. It will directly attack on this carbon and Br will be removed. So right, we will get this one. Then we will do simple its hydrolysis in presence of HG plus 2. So this part will be removed and we have to attach ketonic group or carbonyl group here. So this will be our final answer. Then one more reaction. So again we have to first generate carbon ion. So I am suppose directly removing this proton and we will get a negative charge here, right? This negative charge will attack on this carbon, this electrophilic carbon center. It always attacks on electrophilic carbon center. So this bond will shift here and you will get OH here. Then next important thing, that what will be the attacking side? You can decide attacking side by the side of attachment of these two protons, because they are above the plane. So that is why this group will always also attack from the less hindered side, that is convex face, right? It will attack from this side, not from the cavity side. So what we will first get here, this group will come above the plane, methyl group will remain as such. This oxygen will come below the plane, it will form suppose OH, and right then we are doing its hydrolysis. So this group will be removed and we will have aldehyde group attached, right? This will be our final answer. So we have to remember only two things, that it will attack on the less hindered electrophilic carbon center and attacks from the convex side when you have this type of molecule, right? And attacks on electrophilic center. Then one more question based on it. So again we have to generate a carbon ion. I am directly writing here. So it will attack from on the less hindered side. So it will directly attack on this carbon and Br will be removed, because Br is very good leaving group. That is why it will directly attack on it without opening this epoxide ring. And when we will do its hydrolysis, what we will get, I am directly writing here, that you will get aldehyde group attached here. This carbon will become like this, then this. Then next question is, in which we have two halides here. So you have to decide that which will be your better leaving group. So first we will generate this carbon ion, then it will attack on this carbon and Br will be removed, right? Because Br is better leaving group than chlorine, that is why it will remove first. So you will get this first. Then in next step we are again using this butyl lithium. So I have to remove one proton from here and this carbon ion will again attack on this Cl, this carbon, and Cl will be removed. So what we will generate, we will generate 1 2 3 4 four membered ring here. And when we will do its hydrolysis, then we will get this one as final product. Then next we have question from June 2019. So what they are saying, that the question part is missing in it. The question was that how you can generate this A. These are different reactions are given and they are asking us that through which reaction you can generate A. So we will see all these reactions one by one, and if you have a concept clear in your mind, then you can do this reaction without using your pen. That in first reaction I am using this butyl lithium. So one proton will be removed from here. I will have carbon ion here, which will generate on this, which will attack on this carbon, and Br will be removed, right? And when it will attack here, then I will get this type of structure after hydrolysis. I am directly writing after hydrolysis. you will get this type of structure, right? So this is not your A product. Then in second example, this carbanion will attack on this carbon, Br will be removed. So you will get this group attached here like this, and when you will do its hydrolysis, what you will get? You will get this one. So this is your final product. So option number 2 will be correct. Then we have question from December 19. So they are asking us the major product A and B is formed in the following reaction. So you have to find out that what is A and what is B. So first we will take A. So I am directly writing here that you will get a carbanion like this after removing one proton from this position. Then it will attack on this molecule, right? So this is bulkier molecule. So it will first attack on this carbon, which is less hindered. It will not attack on this one, right? It will attack on less hindered carbon. So your ring will open. So when the ring will open, you will get this type of molecule. Then this O minus will attack on this carbon and Cl will be removed. So what you will get? This one. Then you can do its hydrolysis in presence of HgCl2. So you will get this one as final product. So it is in option number 1 and 4th. Right? A is in 1 and 4th. Let's see B. So in B, this is very simple and obvious reaction that we are doing, that this carbanion generated here will attack on this carbon and Br will be removed. So what we will get here? This one, right? And when you will do its hydrolysis, you will get this one as final molecule. So this is in option number 1 only. So this will be your correct answer. Then we have one more question from GATE 2004. So first you have to synthesize 1,3-diethyne. So we can easily do this one. It will not generate 1,3-diethyne. It will give you different type of diethyne, because we have only this is 1,2-diethiol, right? So it will give you 1,2-diethyne, right? You will get this one, and this is your P, right? Then you will use LDA. So LDA will remove one acidic proton, right? Then it will attack on this Br, right? You will get this one as product. This is your Q, and then ReNiNickel is used. So we know that it will not do it will not generate a ketonic group, carbonyl group here. It will simply do its reduction and will convert it into CH2. So this will be your final product R, right? So this is all about 1,3-diethyne. So I think I have covered all the important parts. Now you can do the problems related to it. And thank you so much for watching. And if you like my videos, please share my videos with your friends.